Fed Sanabria. I am an associate professor of psychology, and I'm in the behavioral neuroscience program. I usually have like an iced latte with an extra shot to keep me awake. We study motivated behavior in animal models, so we try to understand how animals and including humans organize their behavior over time. How flexible this passage of time appears to be, right? So that when we're having fun, time seems to fly. When we are doing something that is really boring, time seems to crawl. And we're interested in that too. We're trying to figure out what are the mechanisms that govern that. We know that, for instance, we can ask animals to keep track of the time at which certain events happen. The events have to be biologically significant, so they typically are food for a, you know, an animal that hasn't had food for a few hours. And what we found is that a lot of people have been wondering whether the level of motivation, how good the reward is, affects the perception of the passage of time, right? Between, you know, these events. And models and theories have been built on this idea that motivation and perception of time interacted. They're very interesting, and that's probably why they got so much attraction. But what we found is that actually when you look carefully, when you separate, when you allow the animal to express when it is interested in engaging in a timing task and keeping track of time, then you see that these are really two very separate independent processes, that the animal sometimes is not interested in the task. If you ask the animal to keep track of time when it's not interested in the thing that they're timing, sure, they're going to do poorly, like you or I would do poorly if we're asked to perform a task we're not interested in. But once they become interested in that task, their performance actually is reliable, and it's pretty, it changes between individuals, so we can see inter-individual differences in their capacity to keep track of time, and that we see the effects of drugs on that capacity, independent of how interested the animal is on performing the task. And so, and I think that's an important contribution, because I think that to some extent goes against this idea that there's an intrinsic and especially intrinsic relation between how we perceive time, how interested we are in the things that we're timing.